What's good, you guys? Welcome back to another episode. My name is Yashwarrier, founder of BeatCurry. Here's something. Do you guys know about this very sacred instrument of Philippines called the Salimbaa? An instrument that was taken away from the Tinananon tribe over a century ago. How did it all happen? Did it get restored? Towards knowing more about all of this, I'm here to interact with an internationally acclaimed musician and a maker, Caleb Byerly. He's popularly known for his immense contribution towards restoring the very sacred Salimbaa, and he has also traveled the world and lived with indigenous groups and has done his extensive research on making native musical instruments. Thank you so much, Caleb, for tuning in. We are absolutely pleased to have you.
Yeah, well, thank you. It's such an honor to connect with you from across the world today. Thank you very much.
Thank you. Thank you so much, Caleb. You know, I would like to start by knowing from you, you in today's time, you're creating some of the most unique and exceptional musical instruments in today's time, that have such earthly sounds, such traditional feel to it. Tell us about the range of instruments that you're creating and what all are the types of it and the specialty with it.
Yeah, sure. Well, I make anything from wind instruments like woodwinds, Native American style flutes, and then flutes from all different types of countries and world, countries and nations all around the world. And then I also make, stringed instruments, and, I specialize in lutes, like lutes from around the world, and lyres, Middle Eastern style lyres, and Hebrew lyres, that kind of thing. And then I also do some drums here and there, like real native skin drums. So I make the shell of the drum, and then get like goat skin or cow skin for the drum. So I mean, it's a very wide range. But what I'd say I really specialize in is helping to redeem old ancient instruments from different cultures and nations around the world, and really help just take those instruments and help them continue to live on and not True. Be lost in history.
Absolutely.
So that's really my passion, and I really desire to make instruments that have quality to it, like real good quality, and right. they're made out of really, really good materials. An instrument that goes into my shop will take a long time to, it'll stay in my shop a long time before it goes out.
Right.
Because I want to make sure that it's made right and made well.
Right. Absolutely. How do you go about understanding the acoustic requirement for any instrument while you're crafting it? In the sense of the kind of wood to use or the kind of strings to use, how would you create more resonance to it? How do you understand that?
It's really just a process, like trial and error, because every instrument is different, and not just every instrument, but every material that you have put together, every material, when you put two different types of material together, they come together to create a different resonance. So it's all about, taking a piece of material and tapping on it, and I make a decision whether I should take more material off, if I should shave it off more, or if I should keep it as is, or let it dry longer, or just not even use that piece. It's different every piece of instrument that I make. It's been a process of just kind of getting better and better each instrument. So sometimes I feel like I'm so far away, and sometimes I feel like, oh, I've gotten it, So it's always that battle, It's like, but it's a joy, and I love that process.
Absolutely. you know, I can right now see that you have a few instruments behind you. If you could play a few lines for us.
Yeah, sure. I've got this is the Salimbaa. This one's kind of hard to see from the video. This is a two-stringed lute, and I'll play this for you real quick. Yes, that's pretty cool. Yeah.
Actually, it's looking, you know, it's a very beautiful instrument, very unique instrument.
Yeah, it really is unique. And it traces, this particular instrument sort of traces throughout Southeast Asia.
Right.
You can see it in a lot of countries in that area, like Malaysia, Indonesia, Philippines, all within that sort of area, there are different versions of this instrument. So yeah, it's fun. Yeah. And here's a Native American style flute.
Wow.
Here.
Wow.
So this is a real basic one made out of just a piece of bamboo.
Right.
And it's got two chambers. So this first chamber, you blow into that, and then the air is directed up and it comes across, and then that's where the sound is produced.
Good.
And then it just has five holes in it, and it plays in pentatonic scale.
Right. Now here's a video of Caleb performing a short piece on his 36-stringed Salimbaa. You've also spoken in length about how you went about crafting the Salimbaa and most importantly, restoring it back to that tribe in Philippines. How did you come to know that what you dreamt was actually a real life situation out there? Tell us about that.
Yeah, well, just kind of quickly, what happened is I was already an instrument maker, making instruments, and then in 2013, I had a dream, and in the dream, I saw basically this tribe of people, and I saw a musical instrument that the chief of the tribe was carrying.
Right.
And so in this dream, I looked at the instrument and I saw basically everything about this instrument, and it was, I kind of like got a full download of everything about this instrument. And then I also heard the name Tinananon.
Right.
So after that, I woke up and I drew everything out. I wrote my whole dream out in my journal. And then, I drew all pictures about this instrument, everything that I saw in the dream. And then I went through the sort of the creative process of putting everything together. And I didn't know what I was getting myself into, really, but it was a much more complicating instrument than I was used to.
Right.
I was used to making flutes and, you know, small instruments, but something like this is more complex and it's very deep. And so it was a very challenging process, but it just happened to be that I ran into someone who was from a tribe called the Tinananon tribe.
Right.
And then after that, I ended up successfully made my first instrument, this instrument that I saw in the dream. And I told that person that I wanted to go with him to his tribe.
Right.
And so I ended up making the instrument, and the one that was in the dream was a 30 string. It has 30 strings. And it was also shaped like a bowl. It was the same general setup of this one, but it had 30 strings. And I ended up just taking it with me on this sort of journey out to this tribe called the Tinananon tribe.
Right.
I took the instrument with me, and I met that man. His name is Manigos. And I went with Manigos to his tribe, and then we met the chief of the tribe, and I gave it to him as a gift.
Well, right.
And a lot of times that we, you know, a lot of times when we visit tribes, we give gifts. It's just a sign of honor.
Right.
And for me, I was just giving him this gift, you know, just as a sign of honor. But when he saw it, he was like really amazed by it, and he kept looking at it, and his eyes were staring at it. And then he said, "Where did you get this from?"
Yeah.
And I said, "Well, you know, I've never seen this instrument before in any other place, but I had a dream about it, and I made the instrument." And then he said, at that time, there were some other chiefs that came into the room.
Right.
They were elders of the tribe, and they came in and they saw the instrument, and they were speaking in their own language that I did not understand. So they kept saying this word Salimbaa, and I didn't know exactly what that meant, but they said, we want to show you something.
Right.
So they took me to down this little path that went to their house of prayer, and this is where they worship the different gods of their tribe.
Right.
And so they took me in there, and I, you know, I saw what they had, and I was very amazed at, you know, these ancient artifacts like clay, pottery, metalwork. They had musical instruments. They had weavings of, you know, for their clothes. They had different things, and I was very amazed. And then they showed me this one section where the musical instruments were.
Right.
And they said a long time ago, and they didn't give me the exact date, but they said like over 100 years ago.
Right.
They said over 100 years ago, there was a musical instrument that we had in our tribe, and it was the most sacred instrument that we used. And they said there was a tribal war, and during that time, the instrument was taken away from us.
Oh my God.
Yeah, and they said that they never had the opportunity to make it again because, you know, the instrument maker or the people who made the instruments were killed, or they ended up passing away and never were able to pass down that art to the next generation. So they said that this instrument that was lost was called the Salimbaa.
Right.
And another word for it is Sinolimba. The real word is called Sinolimba, and it was taken from them. And when it was taken, they mourned, and they had this kind of lament song that said, you know, that the Salimbaa was taken from us, but one day God is going to redeem it back to us. And when it is going to be redeemed back to them, the Salimbaa is going to be coming down from heaven.
Absolutely.
And when it comes down from heaven, and it's going to rest on top of the mountain.
Right.
And then that's when everyone who loves God and cares for God is going to come and get inside the Salimbaa, and then they're going to go back to heaven with it. So that's sort of that's their folklore and about this instrument.
Right.
That's been passed down through the generations.
Right.
And so the chief he told me all about it, and he said that, you know, this is the lost instrument that I brought to them. And I mean I was speechless. I had no clue, you know, how to respond to that.
Absolutely.
I was really amazed, and I was not prepared for that at all.
Right.
And then from that time, we just sort of got to know the tribe really well, and you know, they kept, you know, we obviously they kept the instrument inside their house of prayer, and every time that they get together for tribal events, they play the instrument, and you know, that I've had such an honor of being able to go back and forth and have a really good relationship with this tribe.
Right, absolutely. I mean, like, this is so wonderful to hear, and it is such a touching story. After your gesture of restoring the Salimbaa back to their community, have they been able to create more and more of this instrument so that there's more awareness about it, there are more people who are playing it?
But we have been working on the process of creating a musical instrument workshop there in the tribe. So that way they're able to continue that art of making the instruments. And so we've been working on that, and then we've been preserving the sound of the instrument by doing recordings.
Right.
So we've already recorded a couple albums that really showcase the sound of the instrument. And so that's been really a lot of fun doing that. And then there's been a really big interest all around the world in this instrument.
Right.
So there have been musicians around the world that have been interested in me making one for them.
Right.
So I've made just a few. I think I've made six or seven. Yeah, I've made seven Salimbaas. Just, you know, they take a long time to make. They're very extensive, and I make them for different people who are really interested in them.
Right. You know, you also spoke about your album, Chief. I also had the pleasure of listening to all the tracks. And I think I have to tell you that my top favorite tracks are, you know, Reclaiming the Land, Foundation Form, Dance of the Light. Feel, you know, the entire crux of what Salimbaa is, I felt for me, you know, was expressed so well in these songs. And of course, the entire album. It's genuinely a great effort that, you know, that you are taking forward to, you know, create an entire album that portrays the Salimbaa and, of course, their tradition and community.
Well, thank you. Yeah, I really appreciate that. It's been a real honor. And, you know, for me, I just want to help honor them and their tribe and what God has been doing through them. And it's been great to walk with them through the process. And, you know, when I... You know, we did that album, we recorded it here in the United States.
Right.
And I had American musicians record it with me. So obviously I'm not Filipino, and the musicians that played it are not Filipino either. But so that in itself is pretty contradictory, and I understand that. But as outsiders, we want to just use this as a way of just saying, hey, we love your music. We love what you have to give to the world. And it is an honor for me to just make this music and uplift your country and your people and your sound. So, I mean, that's really our sort of gesture in this. When we first made the album, we took a lot of copies of those albums to the Philippines, and we gave them out. We gave them to hundreds of people. And then we also went to the tribe, and we gave it as an honor to the chief who passed away.
Right.
You know, and so it was amazing when we met with all of the elders of the tribe and all of the people there who were a part of this gathering, and we just presented it to them, and they just started crying, just tears going down their face, and they remembered their chief who passed away.
Right. I mean, this is absolutely touching. You have spoken about it so beautifully. Thank you so much, Caleb.
Thank you. I really believe that there are ancient sounds from different cultures and nations around the world. And we live in a time where things are progressing so fast that if we don't hold on to those sounds, then they're going to get lost in history.
Yes.
They're going to get lost. And so really we want to hold on to those sounds and continue to use them. Yeah, so that's really my heart behind this, is that just let it continue to live on, but also be used for a great, just to be used for a great purpose.
Thank you so much, you guys, for watching this video. I hope you all enjoyed it. If you would like to see more such videos, make sure you subscribe to Beat Curry. Stay tuned, and I'll see you soon.